to our economies within each African community is something that we can't overemphasize. We do approximately $2 billion trade within the EAC, between Kenya and other EAC member states. And that volume of trade is something that many people have not noticed before Corona, given the number of long queues that we have seen at different border points, the disruption that has come as a result of this COVID pandemic. We have been working extremely hard with our regional partners as well as internally to facilitate and make the movements of cargo much smoother than we have encountered on some occasions. We will also expect to see a lot more security through electronic system of health certificates that would be given to drivers across their movements within the East Africa region. And of course, the PPEs and the necessary tests that all our border officials, only the Ministry of Health staff that are being seen as frontline staff, but I think, and so far as trade is concerned, immigration officers, customs officers, port health staff, and all the other people who are facilitating border points are very critical. And so we really are looking forward to making sure that we build on the work that we have done already. I want to once again thank the EU and look forward to working with the Trademark East Africa. Thank you.
And this is part of the European Union's overall response to support Kenya in reacting to the COVID-19 crisis. It's an unprecedented response, with around 40 billion Kenyan shillings of support being made available to help the government mitigate both the health consequences of COVID, and as the two CSs in particular very eloquently said, help support the people of Kenya in mitigating some of the socio-economic consequences of COVID. And what we're seeing today is a contract which is designed in very simple terms to keep the trade flowing. Trade is at the heart of the economy. We've put a particular focus on Kenya here. Why? Because it's the dynamic, breathing heart of the East African community. But Mombasa Port, in many ways, is the entry point for trade into the whole of the East African community. So this contract, in very simple terms, will make sure that all of the workers in the ports, the customs workers, the border officials are all equipped with personal protection equipment.